Bitcoin, Litecoin, Peercoin, Namecoin, Dogecoin, Catcoin. It's the finance of the future with real dollar value. These cryptocurrencies are really no different to the money you have in your back pocket.
Except for the fact you can't see them because they're digital, and now you can even create your own.
Like all currencies, Bitcoin only has value because people give it value. When it started back in 2008, it was worth nothing. But over time, more people began to use it to trade, and its value increased. Just last week, here in Australia, the crypto market started translating into real business. Through a partnership with Bitcoin provider CoinJar, Forsyth Real Estate is the first business in the country to accept virtual cryptocurrency payments for house deposits and property advertising.
We discovered how simply you can exchange Bitcoin for Australian dollars and put down deposits on properties or pay your advertising.
Direct agency James Snodgrass says it's the simplest way to process transactions from overseas investors.
We believe we're going to get investment and business from all parts of the world, but especially in China.
But it's not without its risks. Bitcoin comes with a volatile history. In February 2010, the first real-world transaction was made when a user bought two pizzas for 10,000 Bitcoin. At the time, one Bitcoin was worth less than a cent. February 2011, it shot up massively to just over a dollar. It's wavered up and down consistently since. In January 2014, although it spiked to over $1,000, the price of Bitcoin today stands at around $460, but it's falling rapidly. The current value of the Bitcoin market globally is around $6 billion. Bitcoin transactions can't be reversed and accounts can't be frozen. So if your cryptocurrency is stolen, it's nearly impossible to get it back. There's no central authority like a bank that controls the money, and most crypto accounts are anonymous. Most currencies are formed either because people are trying to make quick cash or because they're trying to fix issues with existing currencies. Although the use of this digital money is legally contentious, that hasn't stopped it infiltrating the market. It's popular in most of the EU, across the US and North America. Most of these markets don't regulate its Bitcoin economy at all, so it's pretty much free reign. Russia's attempting to ban it, and China's reportedly doing the same. Mt. Gox, based in Japan, was one of the world's largest cryptocurrency exchanges. They're currently under fire because of hackers exploiting their trading system. The exchange filed for bankruptcy protection last month, saying it had lost 750,000 of its customers' bitcoins, along with 100,000 of its own. And that's not entirely unlikely. Of course, anything digital can be copied over and over again. So the hard part about implementing a secure digital payment system is making sure that nobody spends the same money more than once.
For what we're using Bitcoin for, we saw no risk at all.
It's only been 5 years since Bitcoin was launched, and it's now one of dozens of cryptocurrencies being used for legit purposes like buying goods and services online. You can even print crypto money like real cash from an ATM in Canada. Banks and governments are just learning the impact these complex digital money schemes are having, and regulators are going to have to step in soon.
So what started off as a geeky experiment could soon become one of the greatest economic developments that revolutionises the way we make and spend money.